Long, long ago, there was a king in Jaisalmer whose name was Rawal Prithvi Singh. His kingdom was very prosperous. He built his capital with latticed windows and large palaces. He also captured some of his neighboring kingdoms. His success made him unreasonable, foolish, and haughty. One day, while he was in his darbar, a merchant came to him and showed him some valuable and precious jewels as he wanted to sell to the members of the royal family. Rawal wanted to sway the merchant with his richness.
"My lord, how do you like these jewels?"
"They are excellent, but I don't know what to do with these jewels."
"My lord, will you not be wearing them?"
"Gold and diamonds are shattered in this palace. I don't want to send you with disappointment. Let me take these jewels."
"Thank you, my lord."
The king took the jewels and threw it into the dustbin. The entire palace was shocked.
"Listen all, none should take these jewels. It should be thrown to the dust. The person who takes it will be punished."
Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, was completely annoyed with this violent and ruthless behavior. She wanted to teach the silly king a lesson. She drove him towards gambling. As a result, Prithvi Singh lost all his wealth and kingdom. He lost everything and came to the streets with his wife and child.
"Rohini, I have brought our entire family to the streets. Will you forgive me?"
"My lord, forget about the past. Think of what we should do to go back to the normal life. Where will we go now?"
"We will not be in the city. We will go to the city of Patan."
With a heavy heart, they walked for many days till they reached Patan city. They decided to stay on the outskirts of the city. No one in the city knew their background. Prithvi was not able to get even good food for the family. He thought about all his arrogance and the way he had ill-treated people. He was pleading forgiveness for all his sins. Rohini, his wife, was a woman of great beauty and devotion. She realized that all this trouble was on account of the divine curse. She was a devotee of Lord Vishnu. To stave off her bad days, she began fasting for Goddess Lakshmi. One day, as she was praying,
"Oh, Mother Lakshmi, what sin has my child committed? He doesn't even have milk to drink. I can starve for days, but what can I tell my child? Please be courteous to us. What my husband did was wrong, but we have suffered enough. Mother, please help us."
After her puja, she came out of her hut to worship the tulsi tree. After praying, just as she was about to get in, she saw a dead snake. Right then, an eagle appeared. It was holding a necklace in its beak. As soon as the eagle saw the dead snake, it dropped the necklace, picked up the snake, and flew away.
Rohini deemed it a boon from God. The necklace belonged to the queen of Patan. The eagles picked it up as the queen was bathing at a pond. It was lying there with the clothes of the queen. When she came out of the pond, the queen could not understand how her necklace had disappeared.
My lord, that was my lucky necklace. I must have it back.
Don't worry. We will announce a reward for the person who finds it. You will certainly get it back. An announcement was made all around the city about the loss of the necklace. A handsome reward was promised to the person who could get the necklace back. In the evening, Rawal Prithvi Singh went to the market to find himself amidst an excited crowd.
What is happening? Why is there so much commotion? What is everybody talking about?
The queen lost her necklace near the pond, and a big reward will be given to the person who finds it.
King Prithvi returned home with a heavy heart. He narrated the incident to his wife. When she heard this, Rohini's joy knew no bounds. She, in return, told him how she got the necklace. In the morning, both husband and wife went to the palace.
Madam, greetings to you. When I was praying outside my hut, I saw a dead snake. Just then I saw an eagle carrying this jewel in its beak. As he saw the snake, he threw the jewel, took the snake and flew away.
Interesting. I'm really glad that you have brought the necklace back. I appreciate your sincerity and truthfulness. Ask me for anything that you might want and I shall give it to you.
Rohini, ask for what you want. Lands, jewels, gold coins, royal clothes. Ask for what your heart desires.
My lord, please do not misunderstand me. I do not want money or land. All I want is for all the houses in the city, including the palace, to not have any lamps lit on the night of the full moon. Those who want to light lamps may come to my hut and light them around it.
It is quite an unusual request. And how will you benefit from this?
I will tell you on the day of the full moon.
Her request was granted. The day of the full moon came. The whole city was instructed not to light lamps. Even the palace was completely dark. Rohini's hut alone shone bright with lamps. She prayed and waited for Goddess Lakshmi. The goddess appeared before her and was about to enter her hut.
Mother, I wish to ask you for something before you enter my house. I have suffered immensely, so has my child has also suffered. You must always be with me. Please do not leave our house ever again. Rohini, there is darkness everywhere. Only your house is brightly lit. I shall enter your house. You have your intelligence to thank for this. I shall never leave your house again.
With great happiness, Rohini fell to the feet of the goddess. Sri Lakshmi blessed her. From that day forth, the family received all the wealth they could imagine. The king got his kingdom back
and ruled wisely with his wife and child by his side.